Yunnan. We're going to Yunnan. We're going to find the long-lost realm of the giants. That's...
inconvenient.
Yeah, that's just what I was going to say.
To the witch's house.
Yes. The woods with the blood red leaves. South of the lake. I know just where to go. I hope she made it back from Alfheim and can bring Mimir back. He seemed nice. Before you cut off his head.
To go there.
Look at this place. This must be a branch of the world tree.
Boy, stay on the path.
Right, I know. I can't believe it was Baldur that came to our house. The Aesir god. Baldur! And you fought him! And won!
Yes.
One of Odin's sons, Thor's brother. And now he's hunting us with his nephews. Why is this happening?
If we can raise the head, you can ask him.
Okay. You know, it's silly, but I secretly hope we find a giant somewhere in that mountain. I guess they really did leave Midgard, except for the serpent. Maybe the last of his kind. Are you the last of your kind too? Is that why you don't like to talk about
my kind?
I mean, your family. Before Mother and I. Where you came from. Mother, the father?
Now is not the time for that.
Yes, sir.
Fucking break! Don't hear me screeching at you whenever you're twiddling your short and curlies.
Leave him, boy.
No, Pat. Well, you already soiled my solitude, so you may as well join me.
You're not hungry.
Good. It's not what I was offering.
Saw your brother again.
Congratulations. And I'm sure you'll let him go and Roger my axe good and plenty again, Let's see the damage. Little canker throat wouldn't know proper weight and balance if it were dangling off his chut. He eating well enough?
I guess.
Good. All better. Now what the fuck else you want, huh? At times he gets so wrapped up in his work, Sentry hasn't the sense to sip or sup. And if he does remember, good luck getting him to cook his own meat. Guess I got all the stomach in the family. Along with the smarts.
You miss him.
What, that spitmaster? What do you know?
I just mean
hey, do you mind? Trying to concentrate here, already on a break from my break. What it'll it be, Shorty? What next? Son? You know, being small like us, that's natural armor. Bless me. Oh, you make up your mind? Was that all there is?
What is the path back to the witch?
First, we need to find a boat. Oh, guess we're not going back to the witch just yet.
Thank you.
exits from here?
That way. Behind the big statue of Thor. So... Mom the axe just to help her survive?
We have the strength to wield such a weapon, and the wisdom to use it for good. She found purpose in protecting the weak.
So, she'd help out the elves?
No.
Here.
Shipwreck.
Well, yeah. I wonder why it crashed. I wish we could have gone on a trip like this with Mother. She could fight, couldn't she?
Yes. She fought beautifully.
So, know any good stories to pass the time?
What kind of story?
I don't know. Mother always had stories. Weren't you told any when you were a boy?
There was a man I knew of long ago. His stories were brief and purposeful.
Sounds fun? Do you remember any?
There was one that concerned a hare and a tortoise.
Like the witch's house?
Unlikely.
So what happens?
They wager on a race between them. The hare is too confident of victory and foolish, while the tortoise is steady and disciplined. The tortoise wins.
You haven't told a lot of stories, have you?
Dutchman. Huh?
The water dropped.
And the serpent rose. Right. I knew that. I know she's really powerful, but you really think the witch can bring a head back to life?
She seems competent in her craft, and we have nothing to lose.
If she can't bring it back to life, can we keep the head?
No, but you may feed it to the fish.
Okay. I bet this will lead out. I'll see what I can fit together.
Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, I got Isn't that heavy?
Yes.
Doesn't seem heavy.
Here. Boy.
It's some kind of drawing. Maybe a map? Oh! Maybe a treasure map! This is locked up good. I think I see another one of those bowls of sand up there. That I drew the runes into? Not sure how we reach it. There's something up there.
Thank you.
Sandals. There are different runes written along the side of this one.
What does it say?
Another riddle. Feed me not, we both are doomed. Overfeed me, I'll be soon.
The answer might be near, like the other.
Bow. Look at this.
Atreus, to me!
I'm coming!
Turn back, Aesir. Guess the gods are welcome here. There he is! I hope he remembers us. How's it going, Charlie? Is your witch friend here?
What is that name?
That's what he told me it was. Or what it sounded like in my head, anyway. Charlie.
What does it say?
Death to the Raven God, Lord of the Hang. Father, she is here! It is so good to see you again! I knew you weren't dead.
Hello!
Oh, can you bring a head back to life?
I'm not sure I understand what... Wait. Where did you get those? The arrows. Give them to me, now!
They were a gift.
Do as she says, boy.
These arrows are dangerous. They're wicked. You find any more, you destroy them, understand? Do you understand? Say it!
I understand. If I see them, I'll destroy them.
It's all I ask. Forgive me. Please, take my arrows in their place. I have no need for them anymore. Now, what's this about a head? Do you have any idea who this is? Did you kill him?
At his request. He claimed you could revive him.
Me? Are you sure you heard him right?
Please?
Take him to the table. Pamela! It's been a long time since I've practiced the old magic. Hold him there. Let's have a look. Well, thankfully his head hasn't decayed much and his brain is still intact. Nice clean cut. Cutting off his head of all people. I sure hope you know what you're doing. Now, hold his head under the water and don't let go. I mean it. That's enough.
It worked!
Let me see him. Mimir? You there?
Yes.
Good.
Oh. Hello, Freya. Been a long time. You look well.
What I did for them. As far as I'm concerned, death suits you better.
I'd bow if I could, Your Majesty. Forgive me. Had I known the witch in the woods was Freya herself, I never would have suggested this.
Freya? The goddess Freya?
You didn't know either. Sorry.
When word gets out that Mimir is free, the wrath of Odin won't be far behind.
You are God.
Leader of the Vanir, once, yes. But no longer.
You did not think it important to tell me.
Are you really going to lecture me about that?
We are leaving, boy.
What?
Now.
You're welcome.
Why did you do that?
We cannot trust her.
Because she's a god?
Erebor taught you nothing, boy.
But she's helped us a lot.
She lied.
Some people value their privacy. Best not to judge, brother.
When I require your council head, I will ask.
Fair enough. Get me to Tyr's temple in the Lake of the Nine, and I'll get you to Jotunheim as promised.
We know the temple. What's there?
Only the last living giant in Midgard. Who better to tell us the way?
The world serpent? Wait, do you know how to talk to him?
Indeed. He speaks an obscure tongue more ancient even than these mountains. None are left in Midgard who speak it. Except, of course, for me.
You do?
It's true. You wouldn't know it to look at him, but Jormungandr is a sparkling conversationalist.
So, Mimir, why did Freya spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
Hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the... Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. He remembers me. Why, you... Oh, no, that's not right. Mokuno Huntunku. Eko no Tunno Funno.
The pain of your loss. He will help you.
Curious.
What is it?
Nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're heading in the right direction.
Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
Is that one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is. It's not far.
He looks kind of mad for a moment.
Now that, you thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me, I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I even see new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
Hang on to it.
That alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find.
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, I can just tell you this story later.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life.
You were taken from this realm.
I'll tell this one later.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace. Yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones?
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Mimir, you were in the middle of a story before. What were you saying about the long war?
Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. Took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Thank you.
nightmare, huh?
What awful pest!
Your skill continues to grow.
Hey, it's another treasure map.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a whetstone? You don't need to make excuses to say hello.
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Ed. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
Poor Fafnir. There's a fine line between ambition and greed, you know.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother was the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half god and half giant? Weird.
Once Björgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted us many wishes. I can scarcely recall them all. You know what? I'll tell this one later.
Please, my fair Gulvi.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
Focus up.
Maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom if we keep an eye out.
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. Chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthor had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel there spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Arimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. And Thamur fell, crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Giant's ring looks promising. Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again. Oh, neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
अपने लुकेट है जिसे जिसे
There he is.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Ready.
Oh!
Keep it up!
crystal. Wonder what it's for. That's Andy. Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw, but how do we get it down? How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Lorable Hafsa, one or two. He god of war. Mane, he Bizli Bhogavanja set a Lora hoy. Sir, Bizli Bhogavanja set a Lora hoy. Like Bapeke edit the Zongo Derbyshop. Bakoko edit the সি বাপেও মারি পেলাইছে তার সি ভগবানক মারা শক্তি আছে তার সেইকাৰণে ইমান পাৰে তাৰমানে কি কয় আৰু তাৰ সেই সৰু ল'ৰা সেইটোই জন্ম দিছে তাৰো সিমানে শক্তি আছে ভগৱানক মাৰিব পাৰে সেইকাৰণে ভয় নাখায় সেইকাৰণে ভাল হৈ যায় দুখ পোৱাৰ পিছত দেখানে সেই ল'ৰাটোক সঁচা কথা কোৱাই নাই সি যে হেৰি হয় সিয়ে এটা নিজে ভগৱান হয় বুলি ভগৱানৰ ল'ৰা হ'লে সিও ভগৱানেই হ'ব না বুজিছা খেলা চাম পড়ো।